Why is it important to know what the school day sounds like? Or are my students not listening? The number one complaint teachers have about students is that the student is not listening. However, when we take a close look at the environment and the child development, it may be that the student is not hearing. Let's examine what the student experiences in the classroom when listening to the teacher. Each child will have a different experience, and the impact of their listening environment will vary greatly. What will remain a constant are the three factors that impact how well the student hears and understands. Three factors that can impact a student's ability to hear in the classroom are noise in the classroom, reverberation, and distance from the source of the speaker. Let's look at each one of those individually. First, noise in the classroom. Whether it is hallway noise, chair noise, student noise, or the aquarium pump, noise in the classroom can cover important sounds, words, and messages. The slide by Dr. Yusko is a great visual of this factor. It is important that the teacher's voice, the signal, be above the noise in the classroom. As you can see in this slide, the ability for a person to see the cell on the left in high contrast is far easier than the photo on the right or in the cell on the right-hand side. We want the teacher's voice to be the slide on the left. The second factor is reverberation, or what we commonly call echo. This is an often forgotten factor that will negatively impact a student in the classroom. Reverberation in the classroom is how long a noise will remain in the classroom. So when a child moves a desk across a room, creating noise, the noise might immediately cover up what the teacher or the student is saying. But it will also continue to impact that listening environment well after the move has been made. Gymnasiums and stair hallways typically have high reverberation or echo, and libraries typically have low reverberation. The third factor is distance from the source of the speaker. The further away from the teacher or the person speaking, the quieter the voice of that person. There is some significant research related to this showing that by the back row, students are missing up to 60% of speech sounds and having to make significant repairs in the messages. Collectively, the negative effects of noise, reverberation, and distance can have a devastating impact on speech received by the student and hence understanding by the student. Why is it a negative impact? I want you to think of the Where's Waldo pages from long ago. But this page has been copied in black and white, and you are now expected to find Waldo without that red and white shirt cue. This is a very difficult task, and it is similar to what children in a class have to do in a noisy classroom. Because their brain is still developing skills, children cannot separate speech sounds and words from the background noise. They are not able to repair distorted messages or fill in the gaps of missed information. Children are still acquiring language needed in an undistorted, favorable speech signal in order to understand information in the classroom. No one would think of learning university-level content in a noisy restaurant. I would like to invite the viewer of this video to press the pause button and take time to access web links to listen to some examples of how classrooms sound in today's school. Once you have completed this, return to this video. Okay, now I want you not to panic. Students are learning in your classroom. What we would like to do is raise awareness of the struggles of listening in the classroom. What you can do now is take time to ask yourself the following questions. 1. Am I creating a listening environment that allows for all students to hear? And 2. What can I do to improve my listening environment? We'll provide some suggestions in the next videos entitled What to Do to Improve Hearing and Listening in the Classroom.